Welcome to another vlog from Gopakumar Rajan. Oriel is the window to the universe and unknown frontiers. An open eye on everything imaginable and beyond. Please subscribe to our channel if you are not yet subscribed. Press the bell icon and select all for latest video notification. Also, don't forget to like and share this video among your friends. Today we are going to explore the Pallipuram Fort. It is located in Pallipuram or Palliport, on the northern extremity of the Vypin Island in the Ernakulam district of Kerala in South India.
Cause we've been told that's the way our world goes round. Walking on the grounds we've always known, stepping on the footprints in the snow. But when it melts, the other ways will show.
Pallipuram is a typical Kerala village on Vypin Island in Kochi. The village is located approximately 25 kilometres from Ernakulam and 20 kilometres from the Kochi International Airport. Its east border is River Periyar and the Arabian Sea in the west. The Pallipuram Fort and the village derives its name from the nearby Manjumatha church dedicated to the Lady of Snow. The church was built by the Portuguese roughly around the same time when they made the Pallipuram Fort. Since the Malayalam word for church is Palli, the surrounding areas of the church came to be known as Pallipuram. Hence the fort is also known by the same name, that is the Pallipuram Fort. This hexagonal fort is the oldest extant European monument in the Indian subcontinent. It was constructed by the Portuguese in 1503. It is popularly known as Kotta or Kotta at that time. This fort was captured and reduced by the Dutch in 1663. In 1789, through the strategic diplomacy of Raja Kesava Das, the able Diwan of the King of Travancore, Karthika Thirunal Ramavarma I, also known as Dharma Raja, the fort was purchased by the Kingdom of Travancore from the Dutch. Actually, Pallipuram Fort is an observation post and barracks than a big fort. Earlier, the fort was used by the Portuguese as a base to check the ships that would ply up and down from the river Periyar to the Arabian Sea. In this hexagonal fort, the lowest internal floor of the fort is raised to a height of 5 feet or 1.5 meters. The gate and the door posts, and the lintels are finely dressed and arched while underground, there is a cellar that was used to store gunpowder. A 3.25 by 3.25 feet or 0.99 meters times 0.99 meters well provided a source of fresh water. There is an opening at the lowest internal floor to the north which leads to the cellar, which runs obliquely from north to south. The cellar is 4 feet high and 7 feet square. It has an underground path which connects some other openings of them. It was said that the route goes under rivers and lands which they used to escape from enemies when needed. And still not pretty sure of that what all things are on the way, maybe some treasures or anything else. Underground way is permanently closed now. There is a circular slab stone, on which was installed a pillar on which the radiating wooden struts supporting the upper two floors must have rested. These structures are no more in place now. Each face of the fort measures 32 feet or 9.8 meters long and 34 feet or 10 meters high while the walls are 6 feet thick. Each face of the fort has three embrasures, one above the other. The central opening of the embrasures measures 2 by 2.5 feet or 0.61 meters times 0.76 meters. The fort could have mounted as many as guns commanding all quarters round it. There is an open space inside affording easy passage to the cellar. The fort is constructed using laterite, chunam or lime mortar, and wood. The walls are thickly plastered using mortar. The doorway in the central circular slab is made of granite. The cellar in the fort served the purpose of storing gunpowder. A living quarter, a church, a hospital and other significant buildings can be found near it. The Pallipuram Fort was attacked by the Dutch in the year 1662, who then occupied the fort. Since it was located in a very strategic position, it caught the attention of other rulers too. The Mysore rulers also tried to purchase the Pallipuram Fort from the Dutch, but due to the intervention of the East India Company, the proposal was terminated. However, the desire to buy and acquire the Pallipuram Fort did not end here. In what is defined as a strategic move, the ruler of Travancore purchased this grand fort along with the Pallipuram Fort in the year 1789. Following the decline of the Mysore rulers, the possession of the entire Malabar area was taken over by the English East India Company. With the passage of time, the Pallipuram Fort lost its importance and was finally abandoned by the military. A memorial was erected by the government of Travancore in front of the fort in 1909. In 1964, the Pallipuram Fort was declared to be a protected monument and has been under the Department of Archaeology ever since. On December 19, 2017, restoration works started and finally, it is open for the public on February 25, 2019. At present, the entry is free. The visiting time is from 9:30 a.m. to 5 p.m. in the evening. It remains closed on Mondays. Thank you so much for watching our channel. Please give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed the video. Your comments and suggestions are welcome. Please stay tuned for another informative video.